Hello everyone, in previous video we have completed content delivery and search spider control. In our today's session we are going to learn redirects, content management system issues. But before starting our today's session, let us discuss our previous session, that is content delivery and search spider control. Inside content delivery we have seen the word clocking. Now what is clocking? See, when you have created your website in such a way that is different for both the person, or we can say human, as well as it is different for the search engine, at that time that concept is known as clocking. And you have provided layout in such a way that would be different in both the situation, which may create violation for the Google Webmaster guideline. So whenever your website contains or implemented using the concept of clocking, at that time the result would be unexpected, because the way the search engine sees the output is totally different than the way the presentation of the in the eyes of customers. So study the potential benefit of clocking. We are having one figure which represents how the clocking works. Over here you are able to see that there is an image of spider, there is a person who contains the page which is created for the human, and one page is created for the Google or any search engine. So one page contains two sides. One has been developed for the search engine, one is developed for the humans. Now there are certain examples of website which contains the concept of clocking, and the major example of that is google.com. that means Google is the most dominant player in the market or in the search engine. So in the when you are going to apply search, at that time Google toolbar is there, Google translator is there, or Google advert tool is there. So when you type this particular website in the URL list, it displays the output as a different format rather than you are just going to click on the particular link. Similarly, there is another site called endtimes.com which provides you to create an account, or when you are going to log in, at that time you need to perform 5 different clicks to create our account or to log in into the particular site. So the attachment are all showing different content to the search engine versus human. Next is called wine.com. when you want to purchase any product from this particular site, at that time you compulsory need to give the shipping location detail. At that time only you are able to see the price of particular pages. So wine.com is the website which contains the concept of clocking, and you people know that form, that's the form the search engine do not have to fill out. Yelp.com, again this is a name of the site which targets a geographical location and which is a cookie based location. It is very popular form for the local business targeting, which contains hundreds or rather than the thousands of sites. Next is called Trulia.com, which is the which contains some interesting redirect on partner pages as well as its own website. Now, how to display different content to search engine and visitors? See, there are various ways through which you are able to represent your content in front of the search engine spider as well as in front of the visitors. Now see, whatever the content you are going to place using image flash and plugin files, that content is not meant for the search engine. So that content is referred as unspiderable format. So you can apply this kind of strategy when you don't want to crawl the pages crawled by the crawler. Similarly, you should not use this format for clocking. You need to improve the user experience. You need to create your content which is readable by the spider. You can also use CSS formatting style sheet, you can use JavaScript concept, you can use cookies and session based delivery, as well as you can use IP address. So these all are the points which are related with the displaying different content to the search engine as well as visitors. Now we are having robot.txt file which you can put at the root level of your website, and you are able to access robot.txt file from the root of your website. When you are going to replace your file with the robot.txt file, basically it prevents the crawler from accessing non-public parts of your website. It blocks the search engine for the accessing index script, utilities and other types of code, as well as it avoids indexing of duplicate content which is available in the website. There are several types of search engine like Google, Yahoo, Bing, Ask. These all are the search engine which is valid for the crawler, and when you are going to use robot.txt file, at that time you can set follow parameters or follow instructions for the crawling purpose. Now commands in the robot.txt are primarily used to prevent the spider from accessing pages and subfolders on the website. Next is called meta robot stack. Generally, meta robot stack contains three components: cache, index and follow. Here we have given the image of cached. So if any site contains cached element, at that time the cached keyword has been written with the name of website. Next is called canonical tag. Canonical tag is introduced in the February 2009 by all the major three search engines, Google, Yahoo and Microsoft. That is a tag which is used to deal with the duplicate content. You just need to write canonical keyword inside relay attribute, which is the attribute you can use with the link tag. Next is called blocking and clocking by IP address range. Crawling or any crawler or search engine gives you the facility to block any IP address, and you can apply clocking strategy. You can restrict access and you can save bandwidth of your website. Next is called using iframe. When you want to hide certain kind of content in front of search engine, at that time you can use the concept of iframe, and you can put that content inside iframe so that content is not indexed by the indexer. Next is called hiding text in images. When you want to hide certain text from the crawler, at that time you can put that content inside the image, any image, because crawler cannot read image properly. So images are not visible by the search engine. So when you want to hide your content, at that time you can hide it by putting inside the images, but it is not advisable. Now, hiding text in Java applet means when you are going to work with the Java applet, at that time with the help of it you are able to hide text, but again this is not advisable. Forcing form submission is nothing but you have created such kind of website which is which forces a form submission to move forward in the website. So when you are going to work with such kind of website, again this is not suggestible or recommendable. Next is called using login and password protection. When you want to provide security or any protection purpose in the website, at that time you can use the concept of CAPTCHA code, and like normal human verification, search engine cannot identify the CAPTCHA code. So this is again the limitation of any search engine. And next is called removing URL from the search engine index. So when you are working with a Google search engine, at that time you are having webmaster tools, from that you can remove the URL of your website. Similarly, Microsoft Bing search engine will carry this type of functionality very soon. So this is all about our previous session. Now let us begin with our today's session, that is called redirect. Redirect means when we are going to move from one location to the other location, or when we are trying to implement new location, that location is known as redirects, or that movement is known as redirect. So when you are going to transfer your content from one location to the other location, that is called redirects. Generally, for example, suppose you have some content at http://www.yourdomain.com which contains old.html page, and when you want to decide or restructure your website, so because of this restructuring, your new location would be on criticalkeyword.html. So now when you want to restructure your website, at that time you need to decide that when you that you want to continue with the old website as well as with the new website, or you want to close old website and you want to redirect onto the new website. So always remember one thing, that when you are going to redirect your website, that means you are going to move your content from one location to the other location. So generally redirection has been occurs when you want to restructure your website. Over here we have taken the example of www.yourdomain.com which contains old.html page, and now when you are going to restructure your website, at that time older content has moved or shifted to the new location, that is called criticalkeyword.html. Now see when and why the redirection occurs. So first point is what, you have old content that expires, so you remove it. That means if your website contains certain kind of content which contains expiry date, right? So when older content is expired, at that time you compulsory needs to remove certain kinds of content. Next is called you find that you have broken URL that have links and traffic. See, when there is a situation where you are having some broken URL means uniform resource locator, right? So that contains a particular link as well as you are having a traffic on that, but the URL has been broken. So at that time you need to shift your content from one place to the other one. Next is you change your hosting company. That means whatever the you are hosting a company, right? So you are converting your hosting company from one host to the other one, right? So at that time you need to shift your content from one host to the other host. Next is called you change your CMS. CMS is nothing but content management system. So when you are going to decide that I want to change my content management system, in such case also you need to use the redirect of the website. And last is called you want to implement a canonical redirect. I am going to repeat the word canonical redirect once again. A canonical redirect is nothing but it is a kind of redirection using which you are telling the web search engine that this particular page is a unique page of my website, or when you are telling that this particular page is master page of my website. So when you are trying to develop canonical redirect, in all the cases redirection is possible. I am going to repeat this 5 points once again. When you are having older content and its expiry date is in near future, so you need to remove certain kind of content in situation. So at that time you need to redirect or shift your content from one place to the other place. Next is called when you are having broken URL which contains links as well as traffic on the particular URL. At that time also you need to use the concept of redirection. Similarly, when you are going to shift one host company to the other host company, at that time also you need to shift the content of your website. When you are planning to change in the content management system, in such cases also you need to redirect your website from one location to the other location. And last is called when you want to implement canonical redirect. Canonical redirect is nothing but when you are trying to give the main, or we can say the content page as the main page, at that time that can be possible with the canonical redirect. Next is called good or bad redirects. So there are two types of redirects. One is called 301 redirect and other is called 302 redirect. Both forms are known as a redirect, or we can say both are the part of redirect, which send a human or a search engine crawler to the new location, but search engine interrupt these two HTTP status code in very different way. Remember one thing, that there are two types of redirect which you can use. Number one is called 301 redirect and number two 302 redirect. Both are the parts of redirect only to send a human or search engine crawler to a new location, right? Both will send into the new location, but when it comes for a search engine, at that time both the status code, that is for 301 and 302, so both the status code will works in the different ways. So when crawler sees that you are passing through the 301 redirect, right? At that time it will automatically assumes that this link is passed from old page to the new page. That means now all the content of old pages are shifted to the new pages. So that redirect is known as 301 redirect. But when crawler sees that you are passing your redirection with the help of 302 redirect, at that time it will predict that it should not pass any historical link from the old page to the new page. So in addition, 301 will lead the search engine to remove the old page from the index and replace it with the new one. And if you use 302 redirect, you would be starting your link building efforts from a scratch again. Let me repeat these two type of redirect once again for those who have not cleared or who might confuse between 302 and 301 redirect. Let me give one routine life life example. Say for example, right now your shop is located at Kalavar Road, right? So now you are shifting your place from Kalavar Road to Raya Circle. At that time, that redirect is known as 301 redirect. Why? Because whatever the older location would be, you are going to close that location and you are going to transfer your content from Kalavar Road to the Raya Circle, right? So that location or that redirection is known as 301 redirect. But now in 302 redirect, what happens, both the shop works parallelly. That means you are running your business on the Kalavar Road also, as well as now you are going to start your new business working on the Raya Road also. So at that time, what you need to do, you need to start your link building structure and efforts from the scratch again. So there are two types of redirect. One is called 301. In that, older page would be closed and all the content would be shifted from older content to the new content. So older page or older location will be closed in that place. But when 302 redirect is there, at that time older content would be remains as it is, and you are going to start one new link building structure once again, and you need to work hard from the stretch. Next is called, in addition to the older version of the page, may remain in the index and compete for search ranking in the search engine. Say for example, the shop which has been there in the index like Kalavar Road, right, which earns enough money from the Kalavar Road, and you are going to create new shop at the Raya Circle. So what you need to do, you need to apply efforts to achieve higher ranking at Raya Circle, or you want to be top of the list at Raya Road. So older version remains as it is in the index page, but now when you are trying to open new shop at the Raya Circle, you need to compete for the search engine result pages. So these two are the types of redirect. One is 301 redirect, where older content is removed and older page is shifted from the new location, where competition is not there with the own website. But when you are going to use 302 redirect, at that time you need to maintain link building structure and efforts from a scratch, and older version of this page may be there in the index, and now you are trying to apply the indexing on the newer version. Now, methods for URL redirecting and writing. There are many possible ways to implement redirect. Suppose you are using Apache web server, at that time it is possible to implement redirect quite simply in a standard file called .htaccess. So see, if you are working with a Apache web server, at that time you need to use .htaccess file. Similarly, if you are using Microsoft IIS web server, different methods are provided for redirection in the Microsoft IIS web server. Many programmers use other techniques for implementing redirects. This can be done directly in the programming languages such as Perl, PHP, ASP and JavaScript. See, there are several methods which can be used for the redirection of URL. There are many possible ways which can be implemented for the redirection. If you are a member of Apache web server, or if you are using Apache web server, at that time you need to use standard file which is called .htaccess. Similarly, if you are a part of Microsoft IIS web server, which uses different kinds of methods that are provided for the redirections. And remember one thing, that there are many programmers which uses different techniques to implement redirections, like like in many programming languages such as Perl or PHP or ASP or JavaScript, this can be directly possible. This can be means redirection may be directly possible. Next is called the default document redirection solutions. So the solution that follows is a specific to the preceding index.php example. You will need to plug in the appropriate default file name for your own web server. You just need to copy the content of index.php to the another file. For this example, we will be using sitehome.php. That means, see, when you want to use default redirect techniques for the document, at that time you need to use certain kinds of plugins which are available in the market, or you can use index.php file. So what you need to do, you need to copy the content of index.php to the another file, and in this particular example we are using sitehome.php. Now what you need to do, create an Apache directory, index directory directive for your document root. Set it as it to the sitehome.php. Do not set the directive on a site server wide level, otherwise it may cause problem with other folders, and still need to use index.php as a directory index. So remember one thing over here, our software or our website contains two files. One is called index.php, and I am going to replace the index.php content. I am going to copy it and paste it in the sitehome.php. So now what happens, whatever the content which index.php contains, we are going to have same content available in the sitehome.php. So when you are going to use Apache directory, at that time it may cause problem for other folder, but we are having index.php as a directory index, because right now we are having both the files, index.php as well as sitehome.php. So now put this in the htaccess file in the document root, and you need to put this particular file in the pre-directory context files, and put httpd.configuration file. Inside that you just need to put index and sitehome.php. So we have setted our root directory as a index and sitehome.php. Remember one thing, whatever the content of index.php file contains, the same content is there in the sitehome.php. And in the htaccess file in the document root directory, we have setted these two pages as a home page or as a root directory. Now when you want to clear original content from the index.php file, at that time you need to clear all the content of index.php file, and you need to set header location like this. So new location has been shifted using header tag. Next is called content management system issues. That means when you are planning to publish a new website, at that time many publisher may wonder that need to use CMS, and if so, how to ensure that it is SEO friendly. So whenever you are planning to create a new website and you want to apply content management system within the website, at that time you need to plan that website to build according to the SEO friendliness. So you need to maintain the friendliness of SEO. Now it is essential to determine whether a CMS is necessary before starting a development of project. You can use a flowchart to guide you through the process. So whenever you are planning to create new website, you just need to create a flowchart through which you can understand the process of your project. And you need to focus on the content management system. You need to design your system in such a way which becomes SEO friendly. Over here, do you need a CMS for your website? Over here, we are having a flowchart which will determine whether you need to have a CMS for your project or not. So there are certain questions which can be asked while you are planning for the website. The next step that involves understanding how to ensure that a CMS will be search engine friendly. Here is the list of basic SEO issues that should be aware of when dealing with the CMS. So when by dealing with these issues, you will ensure a relatively smooth platform for content delivery. So when you are working with a CMS, at that time you need to maintain the friendliness of search engine, and these are the list of points which you need to keep in the mind when you are going to plan about the CMS. Number one, title tag customizations and rules. So title should be clear when you are planning to have a CMS in the website. Next is called static and keyword rich URL, means you need to use certain kind of URL which should be static, as well as it contains a keyword research, or we can say it contains a keyword through people is going to visit your website. Next is called meta tag customization. That means when you want to customize the meta tag or meta description, such thing can be possible with the help of CMS. Next is called enabling custom HTML tags. Means when you want to use any HTML tags, it should be easily enabled by the CMS. Next is called internal anchor text flexibility. Anchor text means what? When you are going giving text to the particular website, at that time it should be flexible. Intelligent categorization structure. Your internal structure should be maintained in such a way that should be easily understandable by the user. Next is called image handling and alter attribute. That means you, if your website contains a list of images, at that time you need to take care regarding alter attribute of the website, because people will come using by watching the images or videos, and crawler cannot identify those things in the available in the software. So you need to take care that whatever the content you are going to put, that should be easily understandable and handled by the search engine. Next is called URL free of tracking parameters and session IDs. So remember one thing, that your URL should not contain any session ID or does not contain any tracking parameters. You need to apply customized URL structure. Your URL must contain keywords. The multi-level categorical structure should be there. Breadcrumb navigation means over here in our previous video, which is based on the unit number 1, I have explained what is breadcrumb navigation, right? In the folder structure, you are having left side of hierarchical structure which represents the navigation from the directory to the folder. So that is called breadcrumb navigation. Keyword rich intro copy on categorical level pages. So each category must contain keyword rich title. Next is called XML sitemap generator. This we will see in the practical session. HTML4, HTML5 and XML XHTML validation should be applied on the website. Pingbacks, trackbacks, comments and anti-spam mechanisms. over here, whatever the problem with a comments or pings or tracks is that they are directions for the spam, because spam may occur while there is a comment coming from the outside. So if you have one or more of these features enabled, you will be spammed. So remember one thing, that try to avoid this kind of mechanism in the software or in the website. Therefore, effective spam prevention in the form of Eskimet, Molum or Defensio is a must. That means if you want to put comments or pings available in the website at that time which may cause a spam, and you need to apply anti-spam mechanism for the prevention form, and you are having list of anti-spam mechanism. These are few of them. Next is called selecting a CMS. Remember one thing, that when you are having existing CMS, right? So many CMS are free, but some of them are proprietary. Proprietary means you need to take a permission before using such kind of CMS with the help of license. And when you are going to purchase a license from a company, at that time you need to give a payment for using that particular proprietary. Many CMS were not designed with a security or stability or search friendliness or scalability. See, in your project also you are going to download the template from the internet. Some templates are free and you need to pay for the downloading of that template. So when you are going to use ready-made template, it may be possible that there are certain security issues or designing or layout or some color combinations are not that much user friendly, or that should not be matched or suited in your mind. In such cases you are going to change either the template or you are going to change the design of your template. Popular CMS solutions that the author have of experience with include Joomla, Drupal, Pixel, Silk or WordPress. Each of these has strong support for SEO. Nowadays WordPress is there in the market, or you may have heard about Joomla or Drupal. Why? Because they have strong SEO friendly CMS. Now CMS is the most important process, and if you choose wrong CMS, it may cause site failure. So always remember one thing, that when you are going to select any CMS, you need to choose it by understanding the requirement of SEO, and based on the SEO you can choose any friendly CMS available in the market. And you need to understand that some CMS are free, easily available in the market, and some CMS are such which contains proprietary, and for that you need to if you want to use that particular CMS, at that time you need to purchase license and you need to pay for using that particular software or CMS. Last is called third-party CMS add-ons. In this particular add-ons, when you are going to use CMS, and there are 15,000 plus plugins available in the market. Out of that, you need to use as per the requirement of your project. And Google announced in the November 2011 that it is continuing to expand its ability to execute JavaScript, and it is known that Google can now index Facebook comments also. So that thing can also be possible if using Facebook. So there are many add-ons means plugins, right? So there are several plugins which are available in the market which are SEO friendly, and you are having CMS, that kind of CMS which are more flexible and for future proof. So I think it may be able to read reviews and implement it with Bazaar Voice or Power Reviews soon, but what it can or cannot execute is not fully known. Remember one thing in the last point, we know that Google announced in the year November 2011 that Google can now index Facebook comments. So now what happens, whatever you the reviews you are giving to the Bazaar Voice or on the Power Reviews, it can be executed or cannot be executed, but the output is still unknown. So to be a safe, one fresh solution to the JavaScript problem is to execute the JavaScript, extract the content from its encrypted form and present it in the plain text format so that search engine can see it. So always remember one thing, that instead of JavaScript, you just need to put your content in the simple plain text HTML form so that search engine can easily find that kind of content. So this is all from my side. This is more than enough for our today's session. In our next video, we are going to see the optimization of Flash content. In this session, we have completed redirects, content management system issues. Thank you all.